History of Pharmacy, Wikipedia Audio. The history of pharmacy as an independent science dates back to the first third of the 19th century. Before then, pharmacy evolved from antiquity as part of medicine. Paleopharmacological studies attest to the use of medicinal plants in prehistory. Sumerian cuneiform tablets record prescriptions for medicine. Ancient Egyptian pharmacological knowledge was recorded in various papyri such as the Ebers Papyrus of 1550 BC, and the Edwin Smith Papyrus of the 16th century BC. Prehistoric pharmacy. In ancient Greece, according to Edward Kremers and Glenn Sondecker, before, during and after the time of Hippocrates there was a group of experts in medicinal plants. Probably the most important representative of these rhizotomoi was Diocles of Carystus. He is considered to be the source for all Greek pharmacotherapeutic treatises between the time of Theophrastus and Dioscorides. The Greek physician Pedanius Dioscorides wrote a five-volume book, De Materia Medica. It formed the basis for many medieval texts, and was built upon by many Middle Eastern scientists during the Islamic Golden Age. The title coined the term Materia Medica. There is a stone sign for a pharmacy with a tripod, a mortar, and a pestle opposite one for a doctor in the Arcadian Way in Ephesus, Turkey. The earliest known Chinese manual on Materia Medica is the Shenong Benko Jing, dating back to the 1st century AD. It was compiled during the Han Dynasty and was attributed to the mythical Shenong. Earlier literature included lists of prescriptions for specific ailments, exemplified by a manuscript recipes for 52 ailments, found in the Ma Wangdui, sealed in 168 BC. Further details on Chinese pharmacy can be found in the Pharmacy in China article. The earliest known compilation of medicinal substances in Indian traditional medicine dates to the 3rd or 4th century AD. In Japan, at the end of the Asuka period and the early Nara period, the men who fulfilled roles similar to those of modern pharmacists were highly respected. The place of pharmacists in society was expressly defined in the Teihao Code and restated in the Yayra Code. Ranked positions in the pre-Heian imperial court were established, and this organizational structure remained largely intact until the Meiji Restoration. In this highly stable hierarchy, the pharmacists a euro and even pharmacist assistants a euro were assigned status superior to all others in health-related fields such as physicians and acupuncturists. In the imperial household, the pharmacist was even ranked above the two personal physicians of the emperor. In Baghdad, the first pharmacies, or drug stores, were established in 754, under the Abbasid Caliphate during the Islamic Golden Age. By the 9th century, these pharmacies were state-regulated. The advances made in the Middle East in botany and chemistry led medicine in medieval Islam substantially to develop pharmacology. Muhammad ibn Zakariya Razi, for instance, acted to promote the medical uses of chemical compounds. Abu al-Qasim al-Zara'i pioneered the preparation of medicines by sublimation and distillation. His Liber Servitoris is of particular interest, as it provides the reader with recipes and explains how to prepare the simple Sayuro trademark from which were compounded the complex drugs then generally used. Saba ibn Saul was, however, the first physician to initiate pharmacopoeia, describing a large variety of drugs and remedies for ailments. Al-Biruni wrote one of the most valuable Islamic works on pharmacology entitled Kitab al-Sedala, where he gave detailed knowledge of the properties of drugs and outlined the role of pharmacy and the functions and duties of the pharmacist. Ibn Sina, too, described no less than 700 preparations, their properties, mode of action and their indications. He devoted in fact a whole volume to simple drugs in the canon of medicine. Of great impact were also the works by Al-Maradini of Baghdad and Cairo, and Ibn al-Wafid, both of which were printed in Latin more than 50 times, appearing as De Medicinis Universalibus et Particularibus by Messieu the Younger, and the Medicamentus Simplicibus by Abengfit. Peter of Abano translated and added a supplement to the work of Al-Maradini under the title De Veneris. Al-Muwafaqsa Euro trademark's contributions in the field are also pioneering. Living in the 10th century, he wrote The Foundations of the True Properties of Remedies, amongst others describing arsenious oxide, and being acquainted with salicylic acid. He made clear distinction between sodium carbonate and potassium carbonate, and drew attention to the poisonous nature of copper compounds, especially copper vitriol, and also lead compounds. He also describes the distillation of sea water for drinking. In Europe, pharmacy-like shops began to appear during the 12th century. In 1240, Emperor Frederick II issued a decree by which the physicians and the apothecaries' professions were separated. In Europe there are old pharmacies still operating in Dubrovnik, Croatia, located inside the Franciscan Monastery, opened in 1317, and one in the town hall square of Tallinn, Estonia, dating from at least 1422. The oldest pharmacy is claimed to be set up in 1221 in the Church of Santa Maria Novella in Florence, Italy, which now houses a perfume museum. The medieval Esteve Pharmacy, located in L.L.A. Via, a Catalan enclave close to Puigcerdà, is also now a museum dating back to the 15th century, keeping albarellos from the 16th and 17th centuries, old prescription books and antique drugs. Antiquity. The Republic of Venice was the first state with health modern policies which requires that the nature of the drug is public. In actuality, 13 secrets survive which were offered to sale to the Venetian Republic. Middle Ages.